Secret number 12, Shepherdship by Divine Calling. Shepherdship in Celestial Church of Christ is strictly by divine calling. One does not become a shepherd out of personal desire. Shepherds are not appointed or chosen by men. You do not become a shepherd because you are well educated. You also do not become a shepherd because you are unemployed. You must receive the divine call of God for that purpose. Anybody that God does not call, but who decides to become a shepherd, will, without doubt, dance to the music of mockery. Reverend Pastor Founder Billy Oshoba was the first shepherd in Celestial Church of Christ. He represented Jesus Christ, the Supreme Shepherd. As a follow-up, all shepherds in parishes are representatives of the Pastor Founder, and by extension, they are representatives of Jesus Christ. God used Reverend Pastor Billy Oshoba mightily to touch the lives of millions of people positively and make them candidates of heaven. Today, Reverend Pastor Oshoba is of blessed memory, but his works continue to speak volumes of him as a real man of God. Reverend Pastor Oshoba qualifies to be referred to as a saint. Some of the spectacular miracles that God used him to carry out are stated as an appendix on page 54 of Celestial Church Constitution for record purpose. As long as a shepherd remains loyal and committed to his divine calling, God will also use him as a vessel to wrought unprecedented miracles. The divine calling of shepherds has an advantage for celestials. Every parish truly has the representative of God, a man spiritually anointed as their spiritual leader and teacher. Such divinely called shepherds do not lead the flock astray. Above all, divinely called shepherds are spiritually empowered to confront and defeat Satan and his evil agents. They provide a comfortable cover on their congregations. When a divinely called shepherd prays for the congregation, there is authority in every word he utters. As a result, members receive fast solution to their problems. The truly divine calling of shepherds is one secret why Celestial Church will remain in the forefront of others in matters of the Spirit. Because of this divine calling, the Church has many shepherds who have little or no formal education, and yet they are versed in the Word of God, sharp in matters of the Spirit, and so excel in their calling. This will not be a surprise to those who are familiar with the Bible. God did not call Noah because of his formal education. Neither did he call Moses, Aaron, and Joshua because they were highly educated. The ministry of Jesus Christ is no exception. The first set of disciples that were called by Jesus Christ was made up of fishermen, Matthew 4:17-22. Apostle Paul proved that this practice is a deliberate policy of God and it has a purpose, 1 Corinthians 1:26-29. For ye see your calling, brethren, how that not many wise men after the flesh, not many mighty, not many noble are called, but God hath chosen the foolish things of the world to confound the wise, and God hath chosen the weak things of the world to confound the things which are mighty, and base things of the world, and things which are despised, had God chosen, yea, and things which are not, to bring to naught things that are, that no flesh should glory in his presence. Humility towards shepherds. The secrets of success that I want to share with you in respect of this divine calling of shepherds is that Celestial Church requires you to humble yourself before shepherds. Do not look down on them because you are either richer or more educated than they. 1 Thessalonians 5:12-13. I have witnessed rich people who made remarks that their parish shepherd was not better than their errand boy or driver or one of their lowly paid house help or employees. Such remarks could lead to form the beginning of their fast descent from the top of the mountain of success to the valley of poverty. Their derogatory remarks against the anointed man of God saw them move from grace to grass. This is one major reason why many people you knew as rich and well-to-do members are now biting their fingers. In case you are one of such people, all hope is not lost. Tender, unreserved apology to the shepherd you offended and let him pray for you. Confess your sin to God and plead for specific forgiveness. The merciful God of Celestia will lift you up again. Avoid evil plot against shepherds. Another secret tool that Satan uses to draw members into the abyss of poverty is that of plotting against the shepherd. Satan can fetch 1001 reasons for you to team up with others against your shepherd. Avoid it. You can advise your shepherd, but do not attempt to control him or beat him to submission. Remember those who plotted against Moses. Miriam, Numbers 12, 1-10. Check verses 6 to 8 specifically. Then Korah group, Numbers 16, 1-33. Check verses 31-33 specifically. Celestial church shepherds are not like pastors of other churches who have abundant physical paraphernalia, especially education, gift of oration, and perhaps money, that make them to easily command the respect of those around them. Celestial shepherds usually start at near zero point. This is because they normally refuse to answer the call to serve until God moves against their resources and renders them financially powerless. It is after they answer the call that God restores them. The implication of this is that it is very easy for an untutored member to eat the forbidden fruit of disparaging his shepherd. The secret I'm opening to you here is that you should learn to humble yourself before your shepherd. It does not matter if it depends on you to feed his family or pay his children's school fees. If you honor him, respect him, and support him with whatever you have, he will not only use his anointed tongue to pray for you, his soul will indeed pray for you. When this happens, I bet that you will go beyond the limit you desire. By the power in the world, shepherds, as true representatives of Jesus Christ, can make the impossible become possible for you. Yes, that is the purpose of their installation as the spiritual fathers and leaders of parishes. Early morning blessings from shepherd. Another secret I want to share with you that relates to shepherds is that of receiving early morning blessings from your shepherd. It is an old-time secret that many people used unknowingly and have now stopped using. A lot of others are not even aware of it, so they have never used it. What a great loss. Shepherds in the years gone by made it a point of duty to pour prayers of blessings on members early in the morning before they greeted anyone. Immediately after the early morning church service, the parish shepherd will pour prayer of protection and blessings on members for the day. This proved highly effective because members then usually succeeded where others failed. At that time, celestial members will first be employed or promoted before others. That is the power of early morning prayers of blessing that truly and happily proceeded from the souls of parish shepherds. You as an individual should find a means of receiving your shepherd's early morning blessing apart from the one he pours on the entire congregation. Make him happy and you will be surprised at how his early morning blessings will open doors of success for you in all that you do. Many shepherds and members either do not know of this secret as an effective source of blessing, or have forgotten it, or have been blinded by Satan from using it. Maintenance of the divinity of the call. Anybody called as shepherd in Celestial Church of Christ is given all that may ever be required to accomplish his assignment. The most important of these requirements is the Holy Spirit, and it is highly volatile. Once the body is not holy, the Holy Spirit departs. In order to maintain the spiritual power endowed upon him and retain the divinity of his calling, it is necessary for every shepherd to do the followings, among others: to avoid things that can debase and or defile him, such as adultery and fornication; to avoid things that can distract his concentration on the job given to him, such as polygamy, that will cause strife and division in his family; to to avoid mingling with traditionalists who could make him compromise and lose the glory attached to his calling, to be contented with whatever resources he has. Eagerness to become rich will lead any shepherd to put money ahead of his job. He may therefore be running after money bags who eventually will disappoint and disgrace him. To study the word of God and feed the congregation with the word of life that can nourish them and make them worthy followers of Christ. To aspire to continue to increase in spiritual gifts by engaging in serious prayer. And lastly, not to forget and not to separate from the origin of his calling as a shepherd in the vineyard. To revolt against the origin is to apply for destruction that will surely come sooner or later. Maintenance of honor and dignity by shepherd. It is important for shepherds to realize the fact that members first see them as representatives of Jesus Christ before they are seen as human beings. Worshippers place them on the level of angels. This means that a superlative moral standard is expected of them, in addition to high spiritual code and ethics. The moment a shepherd behaves in a manner that lowers his prestige before people around him, he will find it difficult to exercise spiritual authority on the parish he oversees. Some of the things that members detest to see in their shepherds are reckless utterances that do not befit a man of God, amorous relationship that is meant to satisfy personal lust for women, lack of affection for members. For example, where shepherd has low-level social interaction with members, this can discourage membership commitment to parish activities. Then greed for money. For example, if a shepherd likes running after money bags and neglecting those who do not have much. Inability to maintain a peaceful and progressive family. Inability to feed the congregation with nourishing word of God and to counsel appropriately. Laziness in attending to members' spiritual needs. Pride in terms of claiming credit for even insignificant achievements. Attitude of invoking curse on the congregation whenever the shepherd feels unhappy. And lastly, uncleanliness, especially in terms of dressing, such as wearing dirty sutana. Shepherds are highly respectable people and must be duly honored. But shepherds must know that respect is earned. Each shepherd must behave in a manner that will command the respect of his parish members. By so doing, the shepherd will not be a stumbling block for members, because members will have no cause to look down on him and end up eating the forbidden fruit.